So we're back at the rig I'm using to simulate the two plate method. That's where we take the supply or feed to the switch. So here we've got the line neutral and CPC from the consuming unit being taken directly down to a switch. From the switch, we've got a switching line, neutral and CPC coming up to the lighting point that we're simulating in the ceiling. The reason we said we'd use the two plate method would be to reduce the number of cables at the lighting point itself. So that makes it easier for us to fit things like LED downlights. So what I'm going to do in this presentation is actually swap out the baton lamp holder for two LED downlights. I'm going to use the easy fit connector from Collingwood in order to make my connections. It means I'll have coming in one cable with a switching line, neutral and CPC, and then go out to my second downlighter with another switching line, neutral and CPC. So that's what we're going to do in this part of the presentation. So let's take this apart in order that we can get to the cable. So in the real world, you wouldn't have perhaps had a baton lamp holder. You'd have wired it directly into your down lights. So let's get rid of this from the first part of the presentation that I did where I explained the connections. So let's undo my conductors, take off my baton lamp holder, then we can look at using these easy fit connectors. Hopefully I've got a little bit better. I did a video on those. That was the first time I'd used them. So take this off like so. Here we go. Let's get rid of that. And to take this off. So remember, this would all be done in the ceiling. I'm just simulating it for testing purposes, which might be a second video. So I've got my cables exposed. Get my easy fit connector. Okay, so we've got switching line, CPC and neutral cord grips up here. Gotta make sure we get these at the right length. So for the time being, I'm gonna get rid of my clip. Let's get rid of that. And look to dress in my cables like so. So straight away we're the wrong way around, but this would be in a ceiling. So I'm just gonna twist it over for the time being just to make it easier. So let's get that out of the way right there. And we can now look at making some of these connections. So let's get it down to length. There is a length specified within the actual body itself, but see if we can work it out. Let's go for that length. Do the same one on the line itself, like so. Let's break all the rules I have at college. Just nip off my conductors. Let's get rid of my CPC sleeve into length as well. Let's see what this is going to be looking like. Okay. And one on the CPC there. So if I'm not too long. Snip that one back. Maybe a fraction longer on that, so let's swap it over for another one. Get pulled up on it. So here we go. So let's push our neutral connection in. Let's push our line connection in. Like so, and then we'll follow it with our CPC connection. Okay, like that. So we're into that position there. The only thing is the cord grip probably. See how easy I had to take out. So probably could have done with going in for the cord grip there. Hopefully these slide straight back in, just proves a really good point this does. Let's move the CPC across to there. And you can see why they call them easy fit connectors, because obviously I had the wrong side of the cord grip, bang, we're back to the right side of the cord grip. We've made our connections like so. All we need to do now is obviously add another one to go to my next downlight. So my first cable is in position. I'm just going to slide the second one in. I've already pre-prepared the end. So in through here, it's just a case of getting them lined up correctly into the right positions. So there we go, and then just pushing them home. So now they are connected, can't pull those out. They're fully in, so position them within the cord grips now, like so. And then it's just a matter of levering this into position. So it goes back section goes on first, and clip the front section down. And we've made our easy fit connector now. So cord grips are in place, can't pull those out, conductors are in. You can see clearly in there as well for a visual polarity. You can see the neutral CPC and line conductor as well. We're ready to prepare the second end for another one of these, and then obviously the connection for the actual downlighter itself. So I'm ready to make the connections on the other end. I've already prepared the cable itself. You've already seen me do that. Just to show you again how easy these are to separate the two sections. And then to open these up, there's a little window in here. You push your screwdriver into both sides of those, and then you should be able to just lever the two sections apart like so. Okay, the only thing I will keep saying is to myself is this cord grip thing. I'll remember to make sure I get the cables into it before I start. So let's position it like so. Let's go move the cord grips up, put it underneath, keep missing that, and then obviously we need to just locate our position. So there, and just push them firmly into place. See how easy that was to get that in. Position it onto the cord grip section, and then the back goes in first, like so, and then we just close down the front in order to clip the two sections together. Cord grip's in place. And again, you can clearly see your connections within there. So that was straightforward. We've now just got to prepare the other end for both the LED downlights next. So I'm going to prepare the connector for the end for the LED downlight. There's two screws in here in order to separate the two sections. So we open those up. Be careful not to lose the screws. Especially if you're on a ladder, obviously step ladder, trying to do them in the ceiling. You've got to be careful you don't lose those, because you do need to undo them to separate the sections. So as they come out in order to separate the two sections. So we're like so, and then we've got to make our connections according to the terminations in here. Neutral line, it's double insulated, so it doesn't need the CPC. So again, undo the screw, and hopefully we can just slide our connections in like so. Tighten those back up. Tighten that one back up. So they're in position. Okay, just to prove it to you, see the LED downlighter is double insulated, so no CPC. We know it's metal, but it's double insulated, so it doesn't need a CPC connection. Then we've just got to rebuild these back together, like so. Put the screws back in. The only awkward part of that is dropping obviously these screws from a pair of steps and then to find them again. And that's our connection then made for the LED downlights. And you can see that we can just easily push those together like so. And as you can see through them, you've got an easy polarity visual check. The neutral this side goes through to the neutral on the lamp. The switching line this side goes through to the switching line on the lamp. And you cannot put it in the reverse way round. So if I was to go wrong way round, it won't actually physically go in. This is a nice little touch. Let's do the next one. So I made the second one off camera, so ready to connect back up like so. And we can now hopefully see the thinking behind the two plate method. We only have at this lighting point in the ceiling, switching line, neutral and CPC coming in and going out, and then we carry on for as many downlights as we want. And then obviously the last one only has the one cable in, making fewer connections at the lighting point itself, and therefore easier for the electrician to install. In another video presentation, I'm going to go on and do the continuity CPC polarity and insulation resistance test of this circuit, because I like the fact that obviously for an insulation resistance test, we have to remove all loads, and this is currently connected. So it's connected across line and neutral and would cause you issues during your insulation resistance test, if not damage the actual fittings themselves. But look at this, you just go and you can easily disconnect them so you can carry out your insulation resistance test with all loads removed. So until the next time, I hope this video has been some help.